Hey everyone, this is Lori Mueller coming to you on Sunday, July 3rd. Happy 4th of July weekend. I am a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator located in Lincoln, Nebraska, and I love stamping and I love to share with everyone and hopefully share some new tips, tricks, and even some new techniques that you haven't done in a while, or you've never been exposed to it, and or it was something that you've always wanted to try and just maybe didn't know how to do it. So hey Brene, hi there. So I have been really busy this last week. I hate to admit this, but I have had so many funerals in the last 3 months, and I just had two this last week. One was a former coworker, and the other one a dear friend's son who passed away from liver failure. So they're both very sad. My coworker, I worked with her for about 17, 18 years, and but yeah, amazing friends. So, but I love to stamp. This is my therapy. It kind of brings me back to in my humble world, and brings me into a Zen mode that I can have happy thoughts and sending wishful prayers to everyone. So it's kind of I hit two birds with one stone. Get all of my thoughtfulness, my prayers, my to-do list, all of that done during my stamping time. So it's also a new time of the year. Our July through December mini catalog is live, along with a Sale-A-Bration. We have so much to celebrate because there are so many cute stamp sets that also have coordinating dies. Then there's new papers that either come solo or with a stamp set. And then there's dies that coordinate with our a stamp set that's available in the annual catalog. So you're going to see a little bit of three of them that I am using for my project today. I'm doing sort of a fancy fold, but it's not gonna open, if that makes any sense. So I'm making a 4th of July project, a card that is using the new silver and gold designer series paper that's available in our Sale-A-Bration catalog. In fact, you know, this is our Sale-A-Bration, and then we have our new mini fun. So many amazing products in here. So that's the big deal right now, as long as well as benefits for joining my Stampin' Up! Family. There's a super cute planner. So if you love planners, this deal is for you. And then on top of that, you know, you can get all of your products that you want, that's been on your wish list, for a discount. So I can't think of a better time to join my Stampin' Up! Family. So, but I think on that note, I'm gonna bring us down to my work surface. It's a beautiful day, and I hope it's the same for you. And I know it's a busy weekend with family, friends, all getting together for the holidays. So if you're catching me live, you're going to see the red button. But if you catch me on the replay, thank you so much for stopping by. Hi, Linda. So good to see you. And if you're spending time with me on part of your Sunday afternoon, thank you so much. And at the same time, if you enjoy my videos and would love to help me share my enthusiasm, my knowledge, my you know, tips and tricks with everyone, please share and bring in our new stamping friends that may not be aware of Stampin' Up! Or who are looking for some different ideas that might intrigue them. So I think it's time to flip on over. Hi, Janine. So good to see you. All right. So I'm going to get us zoomed in here a little bit so that you don't have to squint your eyes for the project that I'm going to share. There we go. But I do want to point out Sale-A-Bration. It is available for 2 months, July through August, and it is filled with a number of products that you can earn free with either a $50 order or with a $100 order. Now, if you place a $100 order, you can choose two $50 items or two of the same one. You can mix and match, however, it just has to stay in the increments of 50 and 100. So first up is this silver and gold designer series paper that we're going to play with. And there are 24 sheets. It is one-sided with some foil, gold foil on six of the sheets. Well, actually on all of them, but you're going to have gold stripes and gold polka dots, as well as silver stripes and silver polka dots. And I'm going to show you how you can alter this paper to fit your needs. And then we're also going to play with this amazing phrasing stamp set. Love the different fonts, the big bold ones, and then you can bring in whatever subtle sentiment that goes along with your occasion. So woohoo to another year, which is kind of a birthday. So these are kind of sentiments that are not your blatant, you know, thank you or happy birthday or congratulations. These are more of the, you know, excitement type sentiments that can really highlight a card as well. And then we're going to see just a smidgen, but I've already pre-done it, is this set of dies that you can get with a $100 purchase. And it coordinates, as it says over here, with the Trees for Sale stamp set that's available in the new mini catalog. So we've got the amazing phrasing sentiments, and it comes with two packages of photopolymer. There's 17 images in there. And then we have this amazing die set that, oh my gosh, so there's 24 dies total in here. And then you can use some of these to dress up. You know, if you remember the old campers that had like the aluminum siding, and so you can get a little ridged wood grain or silver. You know, so this top part would go here and the bottom part would go towards the door. So this would be a fulfillment of two sections of your camper. And then you've got your trees that these are the outlines for the solids. These work with the stamp set, which is all stamping, so you can stamp your images, add a little highlight color, and then die cut out with the die cuts here. And there's so many different elements here to create your own scene, so super super fun. And then I'm going to also use the, this is available in the new mini catalog, Into the Clouds embossing folder. So I don't know if you can kind of see the cloud fixtures in here, and then some little ridges that kind of display the sky, but super fun. All right. Hi, Margaret. Thanks for popping in. So those are the items that we're going to play with today. And, you know, there's a quick glance of everything that's available here. And then if you would like to host a party, either you can, you know, purchase the whole amount yourself or get a bunch of friends together to reach the increment of $300. And then you would get to choose this stamp set for free. So this is a host reward for reaching a order, either single or as a group, that reaches $300. And then the host person would receive that stamp set for free. So amazing. All right, so let's get started with our card. So this is my 4th of July card, and I'm using the striped I'm using this silver striped designer paper that is available in the Sale-A-Bration. I am using the Woohoo from the Amazing Phrasing. I have to slow down when I say that. I feel like it's a tongue twister. So I've heat embossed in red. And then here is that cloud, Into the Clouds embossing folder. So you can kind of see it there. And then the stars come from the dies that I had just displayed, the tree lot dies that's available in the Sale-A-Bration as well. And I've made this into like a little pocket card. So your sentiment or your message would go on the back here. And then it just slips right into this little pocket and fits into your regular A2 card. Now, I did decide on the version that I'm doing today to kind of shrink this portion a little bit, because I know my skill set with the liquid glue, and you know, using a really fine stream of it, you know, is something that I can do, but not everybody really enjoys using liquid glue, and the amount that I needed was really thin, which doesn't accommodate our tear and tape, because our tear and tape is about about a quarter of an inch wide. And so that would be too much to, otherwise your card would be sitting up like this, which is not the look that I was going for. So I went ahead and cut that down just a bit. But this is, I die cut a bunch of the stars, and look at the embossing in there that the die leaves behind. You see those stars in there? Super cool. And then I just put it on a 2x2 piece of Starry Sky and popped it up and put it on the designer paper, which then is on a piece of basic white. But I did my stripes with my Stampin Blend, Real Red Dark. So I colored that in to give me the flag look. So this is what we're gonna make today. Hi, Joyce, so glad to have you here. All right, so let's bring in all of our supplies. And I have the measurements right here with the cardstock and designer series paper that I am using today. And I just labeled it 4th of July Amazing Phrasing, because that's kind of what sticks out. Well, I guess this paper sticks out the most as well. But so those are all of our supplies. So the first thing that we want to do is take our basic red, and it's 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. And I'm going to go ahead and burnish the pre-scored line at 5 1/2. Go ahead and do that. And then I want to put, because this is going to fold like this, technically, but we're going to cut off a big chunk right here. But I want to emboss this piece first. Now I could, and that's what I did with my card, because this ended up being an afterthought. So how many crafters have afterthoughts? And so what I had done is I cut this off first, which I think I'm going to do again, because it gave it a nice clean embossing all the way through without the fear of my trimmer giving it either some, you know, rough edges or I don't know. I really like the clean effect that the embossing gave after my cutting. So we're going to go ahead and mark this at 2 3/4. So I'll bring out my ruler here. And we'll just put a little mark there so that I know where to go. And we'll bring in my trimmer. And I'm gonna go from my pencil mark to this corner right here. So to do that, I'm going to line up my pencil mark with the groove. Now, if you're off just a little bit, no one's gonna know. So it's not really detrimental that, you know, if you're off a 16th of an inch either way, as long as you've got this nice little V, you're good to go. And then the other thing I want to make certain is that the fold is on that groove as well. So I'm gonna bring in my slicer and voila. And like I said, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect as far, I just gave myself a measuring of 2 3/4, but you know, if you're off, no big deal. No one's gonna notice. All right, so now we have this portion and I want to emboss just this side. So I'm going to put my cardstock, and if you can see, maybe if I pull it, you see where this void is, where this embossing image ends and then the end. I want to put the end of this embossing on the fold line, because if I go like this, you're gonna see where the embossing, when I run it through my Stampin' Cut and embossing machine, you're gonna see that void. So you're gonna have like this little straight edge that doesn't have any embossing to it on the front side of your card. All right, so you see where I position that? I have it right on the fold. All right, so let's bring in my big boss. And for this, I just need my plate number one. Oop. And then you want to, if it moves, you want to make certain to go back and position it again. All right, so I'm going to put that on there. I'm going to bring in my plate number four. There we go. And then run it all the way through. Let's see, what am I missing? I think I need plate number two in there. I didn't get enough coffee today. I've been on the go trying to get ready for family and friends to come tomorrow. We're gonna have lots of food tomorrow. All right, let's see if this is the right sandwich. Yep, there we go. So we need one and two and four. And there we go. And it should come out just perfect. Open that up. And there we go. We have our embossing. Now this is the one side. This is what it looks like on the one side. And then otherwise you've got the raised lines. You know, the sky part is all raised. Let's see. I know it's kind of, oh, there we go. So maybe you can kind of see it that way. And then otherwise it's depressed on the other one. Hey, Jocelyn, how are you? All right, I think we're done with that. And now we have our card pocket. And we can now come in with our designer paper, which we need to color and get our flag all set up and then plant onto the basic white. So I think we're gonna do that right now. And I just brought in a scrap piece of copy paper, junk mail actually, because this will bleed. My Stampin' Blend will bleed through this paper, and therefore the reason why I have my basic white as a backing, as well as, you know, making it a little bit thicker, heavier, and gives it a little bit of substance. And so what I did is I started with, okay, I'm gonna flip it around this way. I went with the brush end and went alongside, right along the foil the silver foil. I did that all the way through, and then I would skip one. And just go along that direction because it was easier to use the brush and get a little bit wider. So I've started one where I've done the whole one side, and then I flipped it and brought in the rest of my color. So then I would go along the bottom section of that stripe and finish it up. And these Stampin' Blends are so wonderful because no matter how many strokes you put onto your area, it'll all blend together. You don't see, you know, hard or harsh lines of color that are either overlapping or not meeting together. So this just makes it really nice. And this foil is very forgiving, that it has kind of like an embossed, not raised, it's almost depressed in here. So it makes it, and this is getting skinny right here. There we go. So it makes it easy to see where my edge is with these stripes. But when I saw this paper, this was the first thing that came to mind, is to make my flag, because every year I try to design a 4th of July flag or, you know, Memorial Day. But this was timing perfect with 4th of July, aligning with 4th of July. So I didn't have to look too far to reach my goal that I do every year. All right. Okay, I think I'm gonna sit down. I might better. So I'm hoping everyone is planning a wonderful 4th of July. Either you've been invited over to someone's house, or you know, maybe you're like me and doing a lot of the hosting and cooking. We've decided this year, normally we, you know, get out the smoker and do some ribs and whatever, but this year we're going to try something different. We're going to do a seafood boil. And we've never done one before. We've seen tons of them on either friends' Facebook pages or, you know, Pinterest, Instagram, all of those different areas. So if you have a favorite one, because like I said, we haven't really narrowed down on what we're doing yet. We know it's going to have shrimp, and we know it's going to have corn and little red baby potatoes. But as far as other meat, we're not going to do the crawfish, but we're thinking about like a spicy sausage, you know, kind of like a, I got kielbasa on my mind, but I don't know if anybody has put chicken in there. I do know that we're going to smoke some chicken wings and chicken breast, but I don't know if you boil chicken, if that, I don't know, maybe that doesn't sound appealing. I'm trying to hit, you know, a variety of food categories. All right, we're almost done. And then we've got, I'm going to make a fruit pizza with strawberries and blueberries, you know, that's going to be in a flag. Let's see what else. Oh, we just got, my fridge is packed. I have no space to put anything else in there. We've eaten all of our leftovers. Let's
so that we could make space in our fridge, but oh, it's packed. We have no room in the inn in the refrigerator category. So when our friends come over with their foods, I'm hoping that they're well chilled. I mean, some of this stuff will come out, but it's still not going to make much room. We're horrible. All right, now I see that some of my lines did not quite reach the foil area, so I can just come along here. I was trying to do this in a hurry, so I knew I was going to miss a few things, but this way I show you how easy it is, and the fact that me going back over these lines, it's not showing any harsh, you know, and it probably wouldn't even matter because these stripes are so abstract, but I can see them, so I'm gonna fix them. There we go. Oop. All right. Oh, I see a big one right here. All right. I think I got it. Oh, here's a biggie. Oh, I guess this will be covered by my stars anyway, so no big deal. So this is what it looks like after I'm done coloring, and then look at the bleeding. So, and it would do it on your regular cardstock as well, but the designer series paper does add, but isn't that neat? Ooh. But it is a little bit thinner than our cardstock. So this can be planted immediately to the basic white layer, and you can use your favorite adhesive. Hi, Linda. So good to see you. Oh, good thing about replays. You can catch my replay, or maybe you'll just get the gist of it popping in right now. So thanks for coming by. So good to see you. And then we are done on that part. Now the base, I'm going to go ahead and add my liquid glue. And again, I'm just going to put a really thin stream on the bottom here. And I'm not going to press too much, but that'll dry really quick. But you're going to see that I did shorten. I made this version smaller, because you're seeing more red around there. So now to add our stars. And so what I've done is already pre-die cut all the stars, because I didn't want to have to, it took a little bit, because the star die has, there's three of them. And it's part, oh, I just lost it. It is part of the die set and the Sale-A-Bration. So right there's our stars. And so you can see the embossed section in the center there. Super fun. And the fastest way I found to add these is I made enough to where I would start with the four corners and just about like that. And then I went in the center of each, and because this was liquid glue, I'm able to move things around a little bit. So I'm going to bring in my take your pick tool and start setting them down, and I want to make certain I'm grabbing these with the embossed. I got the glue just a little too close to the edge, but so I want to make certain I'm doing the embossed edge up front or on top, Oh, I got a little heavy with the glue there. But it'll all dry. Is there two? Oh, it felt like there were two in there. Oh, and then I flipped it upside down. There we go. Let's see, there's that one. And you know, with this take your pick tool, it just made it go so fast and easy. All right, so I've got my, now I'm gonna come in and do a little dab in the center. There we go. Because then I'll fill in between. And at one point I was thinking of the 13 colonies and just doing the 13 stars that are in a circle. And then I thought, well, the more I started die cutting these stars, then I thought, well, I'm gonna try and do it this direction. So you can, you know, if you're from the, that's one thing that's on my bucket list. I wanna get out to the New England states and see all the history out there. I've made so many wonderful friends that live out there. And yeah, it's just so, so cool. All right, flip these, get these. And I hope I die cut more than what I need. Oop. There we go. Now, let's see, this one needs to go over. I can see that. There we go. Now I'm gonna fill in between. A little dollop. So I did three rows of five, and then I'll do two rows of four. And this glue stays, it doesn't dry that fast. So it allows me, gives me a window to put these on. Let's see, that one's facing up. And this, like I said, this take your pick tool for $10 tool. It's got, oh, it's saves a lot of time and frustration because these things are, they're tiny. And, you know, for anybody who has nails or doesn't have nails, it just makes the job a little slower. Oh, good. I have all those extra stars. I can put those off. And now we are going to, look how fast that went. Now we'll add some dimensionals. Because I love dimension. Dimension and texture. That's always my number one goal. I just think it adds that extra wow factor. Don't want to mix those up with my stars. And then we'll put it, we'll edge it with the designer paper and slip it inside here like that. All right, so we're almost home with what we need. I noticed I forgot to add designer or the basic white for my sentiment. So now we're gonna do some stamping of the woohoo. And it does, it's all one word, but it's just connected by a thin piece of photopolymer. And I like to add the assurance that I'm going to get a nice bold color of red. It dries really, really quick. So here's a tip that I like to share. I'll ink up my sentiment first with Versamark. Okay. Oh, and did you notice that, I mean, this is my old one, but in the new mini, the embossing buddy's back. It's back. Ooh. Oh, no. Nope. No, it's not. I don't know what I'm thinking of. That's crazy. All right. And then, I am thinking correctly. See, it's right there. The embossing buddy and the brush and a tool tray. So, oh, I didn't think I was seeing things. All right, so I've inked it up with Versamark. And now I'm going to bring in my real red and add ink to my stamp. And we'll go ahead and stamp it just like you do if you're just doing one phase of the ink. And then I'm going to bring it in to my clear embossing powder. You want to shake off the excess or kind of tap it so that you get a nice smooth. Let's move some of these things away. Close my red so it doesn't dry out. All right, now we can heat emboss. I know, Brune, isn't it exciting that we have the embossing buddy back? Oh, we have been sandboxing. And what I mean by that is there's a little area where stampers, crafters, demonstrators, anybody who has a wish list, you know, it's like, oh, it'd be nice if we had this. And I know it's been begged. I mean, we have been begging and pleading to get the embossing buddy back for a long, long time. So it's back. But look at it. Oh, I just love that shine. The boldness of that sentiment is awesome. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and start trimming my woohoo. So like I said, this could be used as a retirement card. It could be used as, you know, graduation. I mean, I know that those are kind of here and gone. There are summer graduations from colleges. So those will be coming back up again. And you're just going to give it a nice little trim. Now this one we don't have a die for, although it would be nice, but little things. All right. And then you can, you know, give it as much of a white border as you want. You can make this any color that you want, doing the same thing that I just did, inking up the sentiment with Versamark. And then adding your colored ink. And it just allows the ink to stay wet a little bit longer so that it grabs a nice coating of your embossing powder. And I'm using clear on this one because I wanted to see the real red. And when you do that technique, you're going to want to clean your image after every use. Otherwise, I do have a Versamark ink pad. This one is my nice, clean version. But I do have one that has gotten muddied, which, you know, is no big deal because the ink is not going to transfer onto your next project because you're covering it with embossing powder anyway. So, but you can have a dirty, muddy one too. Kind of like a dirty martini. So, I don't know why I'm thinking martinis, but we have a restaurant that serves all sorts of I mean, funky martinis. There's some good ones there. And we used to go there every now and then, but we haven't been there for a long time. So maybe that's why I've got it on my mind. I have a taste for one of my favorites. It was kind of a coffee martini. All right, and then we just kind of wiggle around this word. Like I said, you can go as deep or as narrow border around your sentiment as you'd like. I always forget I need to go a little bit further than the edge of mine. And I'm just going to get this out of my hands here. Make it go faster. And see, I need to go past my point of turn. All right. So you have to tell me, what is your favorite item that you have seen in the new mini catalog? I know a big one right now is the gnomes. Oh my gosh. I have a dear sweet friend. She is a gnome fanatic. And I think she has one for every holiday. I think about her every time I see one at the store. And then I would love to know what your favorite Sale-A-Bration item is. I don't know. Those hippos are so stinking cute. It's just, yeah, beyond words. So, so cute. All right, now I'm going to bring in some minis on this one. There we go. Oop. And put it in between here. And then for the H and the explanation point, I'm going to trim off this outer edge, because those areas are kind of skinny right there. Put that and right there. Perfect. And we want the woo first. And you can position this however, like that. I always like to add a little slant, a little kittywampus, as I like to say. Oh, excuse me. All of a sudden I got a tickle. And then we'll add the hoo. And that, my friends, is our 4th of July bleh, card. And so you can see where I have less of a border on the background of this pocket for this one. And I I cut this portion, I trimmed it down, I think like an eighth of an inch. So that way you could accommodate your stream of liquid glue here and still have a nice even border all the way around your card. So you'll write your message on the back and plop it in there, and it fits into a regular envelope, which I just happen to have right here. So it'll fit in there just perfectly. And then you can always, no envelope should go naked. So you want to add something to that. But again, this is our, you can get this stamp set with a $100 purchase. You can get the designer series paper because you can use blending brushes. See the example here, they use blending brushes to color it in. Stampin' Blends, you can get that with the $50 purchase. There's 24 sheets in there. And then I used a small portion of the dies here. I just used the stars, which is a $100 purchase. but it does coordinate with the stamp set, so you can't go wrong. And then if you want to, you know, get everything at a super discount, and you're also eligible for Sale-A-Bration, once you start purchasing, you can buy the starter kit and join my Stampin' Up! Family. Get this amazing planner kit, and it's free. You get that whole kit for free. This is what it looks like. Isn't that awesome? Oh, I just so beautiful. I've gotten mine. I haven't put it together yet, so I don't know if maybe I want to do that via a video, or maybe on my own, and then kind of show it off with some tips on things that I found worked better for me in assembling it. But yeah, $99, you get to choose $125 in product, anything you want, and then you get this nice, amazing planner, as well as a stamp set. Comes with a stamp set and everything that comes along with it. So that's our story for today. So woohoo, happy 4th of July. There we go. All right. What'd you think? Pop, pop, bang, bang. I don't know if you can hear the fireworks, but they've been going crazy for the last 2 days. So, and my poor little pooch, my mother-in-law's dog is not doing well. First thing in the morning is when we can get her to go do her thing, but otherwise she camps out and hides, which is so sad. It just breaks my heart. So thank you, Linda. So thank you for the compliments. So if you can give me some hearts and share the love with all of your stamping community, I would be very, very grateful. And I want to wish everyone a wonderful 4th of July weekend. Please be safe, and watch out for, you know, any dangers and fires, and, you know, just stay safe, my friends. So until then, I will see you next Sunday for another series of Sunday Stampin' Dreams with Lori Mueller. Have a great one, everyone. Bye.